Hello, doctor here. In this video, we are going to see many ways of selecting stuff in Word. Let's start with the simplest one, Control A. Now, the reason you may want to select all is there are fields or a table of contents or formulas across the document and you want to update all of them. So select all, right click and say update fields. All of us drag mouse and select like this. But what you can also do is now press Control key, drag again. Keep pressing Control, drag again. So that's how you can multi-select. And whatever you do will apply to all of them. Now let's talk about selecting. But when I double click, it selects the word. If I triple click, it selects the paragraph. If I go on the left side of the paragraph, you see the cursor shape changes. Now if I do one click, it will select the line. And if I double click, it will select the paragraph. Paragraph is made of sentences. So this sentence started here, sentence ended here. Keep pressing the Control key and then click anywhere. It figures out where the sentence begins and ends and selects it. Keyboard has a special shortcut called Extend Select, function key 8. First thing you have to understand is there is a beginning position of the cursor. And then you use different types of arrow keys to move from one place to another. So the cursor was here in the beginning. Then I pressed down arrow, cursor came here. That's all navigation keys do. But while that is happening, if I press shift key, whatever is intervening will be selected. That's how selection works with keyboard. Yes, there are different shortcuts. So control down arrow, take me to the next paragraph, next paragraph, next paragraph, previous, previous, previous. So if I'm somewhere and I press shift control down arrow, we'll keep selecting paragraphs. Now, sometimes I want to select using keyboard, but I don't want to keep pressing the shift key all the time. So instead of that, I go to the beginning, press function key 8. That's called extend selection. Means now I am sort of in selection mode. You can see it at the bottom here. In the status bar, you'll see extend selections. This extend selection will not be seen by you in the status bar. You have to enable it. How do you do that? Right click in the status bar and make sure selection mode is visible here. Now what does extend selection mean? Whatever is currently selected, I can keep clicking somewhere else or even using arrow keys right, left, up, down. It keeps selecting stuff. So when you finish, press escape. Now the mode is gone. Now this key called F8 is also having another purpose. We saw that double click selects a word. So now I'm going to select F8. Nothing happened. One more F8, word was selected. One more F8, sentence. Another F8, paragraph. And now whole document. So that's how F8 is a layered command. And if you want to reduce the selection, shift F8. So right now the whole document is selected. Shift F8, paragraph, then lesser than that sentence, lesser than that word. The next one is very interesting. Look at this numbered list. It's a very badly done thing because these are not proper numbers. This I manually type 1-2-, very bad. Problem is if I select this and try to apply proper numbering, it's not going to work. So before I can apply numbering, I have to get rid of these unwanted numbers. The only way to do that seems to be select, select, delete, delete. No, I don't want to do that repeatedly. So here is the solution. First of all, go to the beginning, click. And now press the Alt key. Keep pressing the Alt key and drag. Now it suddenly and miraculously selects vertically. Select the unwanted part and cut it, Control X. And now I can apply proper numbering. Job done. If you don't want to use the mouse, click in the beginning, Shift Control F8. Now the cursor almost disappears. It becomes a vertical, very faint gray color cursor. Now use the keyboard keys. I'm using right arrow, down arrow, page down, whatever. Same selection, Control X to cut. Now let's see how to select a cell. Most of us try to do something like this. It is working, but cumbersome. So using mouse, the correct way of selecting a cell is observe the mouse cursor. This allows you to drag the column widths. Same thing, the cursor will change to an arrow like this. While it is shown one click, select the cell. Now, if you want to do this using keyboard, what do? Go to the next cell tab. When it goes to the next cell, it anyway selects it. But we don't want to select that cell, we select the previous one. So shift tab. So tab, shift tab will select the current cell, except for one cell. The last row and column means the last cell in the table. If I press tab, now it's going to add a new row. So only for the last cell, the exception is press shift tab first, then press tab. One more very nice feature in Word is I can create bookmarks. And one of the things you can use with bookmarks is quick selection. So now I'm going to select this area manually first. Then I'll go to insert bookmark and I'll call it demo, add it. That's all right. So now I'm far away from that place. Now I press Ctrl G, means go to. We have various things. We have bookmark. And now I'll see the bookmark. When I click on it, it will not only go there, it will select it. Another way of selecting. Now here is a very complex long document. Suppose I wanted to select this whole chapter. So when I right click on a heading and say select heading and content, the content across the entire hierarchy below that level will be selected. Now similar selection you can do in outline view as well. View, outline view. In outline view, the main topics are shown, heading one are shown like this. And next to all types of headings, there is a plus or minus sign. So if this was a main heading and I click on it, notice what happens? Everything under it got selected. So that's another way of selecting large amount of data quickly. Another interesting one is I want to do find across document and select all instances of a word or a phrase. To do that, I will go to find replace. I'm going to find the word called formatting. Don't want to replace it. I just want to go to find tab, not replace tab, and say find in main document. Now it has done it. So that's how you select anything across the document instantly. Remember, find in works with selection, document, header and footer, comments, and more. This document does not have heading styles. This is manually formatted. And because of that, I'm not getting any benefits of using styles. So I want to retrofit styles here. To do that, I'll have to go to each one of them, which looks like this, and apply heading one manually. Of course, inefficient. So what do I do? Click on one of the items, and I'm going to go to editing, select text with similar formatting. That's exactly what I wanted. So it has gone ahead across the document and selected all items with the same formatting. And now I can apply heading one, heading two, whatever I want. That brings us to the end of our session on word selection. If you did find it useful, then feel free to share it with your loved ones, colleagues, friends, so that maximum number of people can become more efficient faster. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.